For us today is the power to prevail over sin. Praise the Lord. It's a continuation of last week's topic. Praise the Lord. Power to prevail over sin. Let's look at the Bible passage. Let's pull up our Bible, 1 Corinthians. 1 Corinthians chapter 5. I need a fast reader. And if you have the mic for Prince, you call it the Praise the Lord. 1 Corinthians chapter 5 from 1.
1 Corinthians chapter 5. It is reported commonly that there is fornication among you, and such fornication as is not as much as made among the Gentiles.
Jasmine, to the mic, please. Praise the Lord.
1 Corinthians chapter 5. It is reported commonly that there is fornication among you, and such fornication as is not so much as named among the Gentiles, that one should have his father's wife. And ye are puffed up, and have not rather mourned, that he that hath done this deed might be taken away from among you. For I verily, as absent in body, but present in spirit, have judged already as though I were present, concerning him that has so done this deed. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, when ye are gathered together, and my spirit, with the power of our Lord Jesus Christ, to deliver such an one unto Satan for the destruction of the flesh, that the spirit may be saved in the day of the Lord Jesus.
Praise the Lord. Praise Master Jesus. Where are you, Jasmine? Praise the Lord. I continue from. He said, your glory is not God. It's not good. Do you not know that a little leaven leavens the whole lump? Therefore, purge out the old lump, since you truly are unleavened. For indeed, Christ our Passover was sacrificed for us. Therefore, let us keep the feast, not with old living, nor with the living of malice and wickedness, but with the unleavened bread of sincerity and truth. Praise the Lord. He said, I write to you in my epistle not to keep company with sexually immoral people. Yet I certainly did not mean with the sexually immoral people out of this world, or with the covetous, or extortioners, or idolaters. Since then you would need to go out of the world. But now I have written to you not to keep company with anyone named a brother who is sexually immoral, or covetous, or an idolater, or a rivaler, or a drunkard, or an extortioner, not even to eat with such a person. For what have I to do with judging those who are outside? Do you not judge those who are inside? But those who are outside, God judges. Therefore, put away yourselves the evil person. Praise the Lord. Now you find out that this Bible passage is talking about the body in the church. Praise the Lord. He's not referring to those outside the church. He's referring to those who are called according to the will and the purpose of God. Praise the Lord. I said, Lord, what do you mean? He says, sin is not the problem. He said, but lack of knowledge is the problem of his children. Praise the Lord. He said, ability to prevail any circumstances is found in Christ Jesus. Praise the Lord. So it's not enough for me to stand and say, oh, thou shalt not do this, thou shalt not do that, thou shalt not do this, do that. Yes, it's good, because that's what the Bible says. Praise the Lord. But he's telling us there is something, there is somewhere where our ability is found. Praise the Lord. He said, Christ is our ability. He came that we will be like him. Praise the Lord. He said, there is nothing immoral. There is nothing filthy. There is nothing dirty. There is no lie that will be able to enter the kingdom of God. Praise the Lord. There is nothing that is not clean that will be found there. And the righteousness of a man is like a filthy rag before God. Praise the Lord. Then how do we come out of it? Praise the Lord. You know, the sin of adultery, you know, when you call on that one, is a big one. But for everyone, it's not the case. Praise the Lord. A man of God said that Satan has different bets for different people. He said the bet he will use for A will not be the same bet he will use for B. To some is gossip, praise the Lord. To another is lying. To another is cheating. To another is adultery. I know all of them has different degrees of penalty, of different degrees, but I think the worst of it is that of adultery, because our body is his dwelling place, is his temple. Praise the Lord. But even at that, if you lie and then end up in hell, you're still the same place with someone who has stolen and murdered. Praise the Lord. So how do we come out of all these things and get to a point where we begin to be who he has called us? Praise the Lord. If you look at 1 Corinthians again, the same chapter 6, if you look at from 8, it says, know you yourself, do wrong and cheat, and you do these things to your brethren. Praise the Lord. He said, do you not know that the unrighteous will not inherit the kingdom of God? Do not be deceived, neither fornicators, nor idolaters, nor adulterers, nor homosexuals, nor sodomites, nor thieves, nor covetous, nor drunkards, nor rivalries. Rivalries are, what is it? I think it's excessive partying. Praise the Lord. Nor extortioners will inherit the kingdom of God. And such were some of you, but you were washed, but you were sanctified, but you were justified in the name of the Lord Jesus and by the Spirit of our God. Praise the Lord. You know, there is one thing I mentioned at the beginning. I said sin is not the problem, but knowledge is the problem. Praise the Lord. He said, let's read that 11 again. He said, as such were some of you, but you were washed, but you were sanctified, But you were justified in the name of the Lord Jesus and by the Spirit of God. So the day he died was the day he washed us, was the day he washed us with his blood, was the day we were sanctified, praise the Lord, was the day we were justified, praise the Lord. But then he said we should not dwell in sin, that grace may abide, praise the Lord, or abound, praise the Lord. So then how do we do that? How do we come to the point where we have the ability to stand and contend with flesh, praise the Lord? Because there is a war, that's what Galatians says, a war between flesh and the spirit. But the life he has given us is a life of the spirit. And outside the spirit, the flesh is ruling. The works of the flesh is what I was explaining. Praise the Lord. First Corinthians explained. If you go to Galatians, it's there. If you go to Romans, in all the New Testament, the works of the flesh are displayed. Praise the Lord. And Galatians specifically said, it's either you are in the spirit or in the flesh. The two cannot stand. Because Jesus already said, there is no standing on the fence. Do we understand it? There is no one allowed in the kingdom of God to stand in the fence or on the fence. Praise the Lord. Imagine your fence and someone sitting on it. The person must be a stranger and wants to invade your home. Praise the Lord. Because if you're coming in, if you're a member, you should dwell in the spirit. Because that's the life he has called us. Praise the Lord. Let's go to the book of 1 John. 1 John. Chapter 1 to 10. The book of 1 John, chapter 1, if you find it, from 1 to 10.
That which was from the beginning, which we have heard, which we have seen with our eyes, which we have looked upon and our hands have handled, all the word of life. For the life was manifested, and we have seen it, and bear witness, and show unto you that eternal life, which was with the Father, and was manifested unto us. That which we have seen and heard declare we unto you, that you also may have fellowship with us. And truly our fellowship is with the Father, and with the Son, Jesus Christ. And this thing is right to be unto you, that your joy may be full. This day is the message which we have heard of him and declare unto you, that God is light, and in him is no darkness at all. If we say that we have fellowship with him and walk in light, in darkness, we lie and do not the truth. But if we walk in the light, and as he is in the light, we have fellowship one with another. And the blood of Jesus Christ, his Son, cleanses us from all sins. If we say that we have no sin, we deceive ourselves, and the truth is not in us. But if we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. If we say that we have not sinned, we make him a liar, and his word is not in us.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Praise Master Jesus. You see, there is no way you walk in the light and then walk in the dark as well. He said, let there be light, and there was light. When light shows up, darkness fades away. Praise the Lord. When I finish reading 1 Corinthians chapter 5, I say, Lord, what was that? It said, any man or any woman, any child of God that is walking in that manner of lifestyle, he said, does not have my life in them. Praise the Lord. Or they have my life in them but does not know. And the only way you will not know is when there is no fellowship. So he has called us to fellowship with him. So when we fellowship with him, that is where he pours his ability. That is when knowledge begins to come. As we come to the church every week, you notice that you begin to learn things. You begin to become aware of your identity. Praise the Lord. Because if you know who you are really, if you know the power that is at work with you, if you understand the workings of the Holy Spirit, then you will know that you're not allowed to dwell in the flesh or walk in the flesh, because the flesh is where that sin dwells. Praise the Lord. Flesh is where sin rules. Flesh is the place of weakness. Flesh, there is no strength in it. There is no ability. Praise the Lord. Before Christ came, men didn't carry the Holy Spirit in them. Praise the Lord. God sent angels to help them. But in our dispensation, our story is different. Praise the Lord. Now, there is a stream that runs within us from the throne of grace. That stream is where your ability resides. It is in the fellowship with him that we find strength. Praise the Lord. 1 John chapter 1 verse 7. It says, but if we walk in the light, as he is in the light, we have fellowship with one another, and the blood of Jesus Christ, his son, cleanses us from all sin. So each time we approach, each time we have fellowship, each time we dwell in his presence, there is something that flows. Praise the Lord. It's called the blood of Jesus. So as we are gathered here now, there is a flow of the blood, cleaning us, giving us his power to overcome sin. Praise the Lord. The reason why there is struggle is because we are not dwelling in the Spirit. Praise the Lord. So when you are not in the Spirit, you're in the flesh. Praise the Lord. How do we dwell in the Spirit? You just be in the Spirit by the Word. Praise the Lord. You acknowledge every good thing in you. Do you know that the Spirit, the Holy Ghost, ministers to us as well? When Jesus was praying at the Garden of Gethsemane, when he was about to go to the cross, do you not know that he was strengthened by an angel? Praise the Lord. He couldn't have gone through. He said, Lord, let this cup be taken from me. Praise the Lord. He prayed and until he was strengthened to go through. So in the place of prayer, we are strengthened to walk out of sin, to walk out of difficult situations. Praise the Lord. Some of the things that we go through, some of them are demonic. Do you get it? Some of them are spiritual. And there is a dominion spirit. That spirit of dominion is the Holy Spirit. Praise the Lord. When you begin to walk with him, his ability begins to walk with you and in you. Praise the Lord. I know how my life was when I don't know him. Even though I was a vibrant Christian. Do we get it? Even though I was a prayer warrior. Praise the Lord. But now I have known him. And my life is better because I fellowship with him and I take his strength every morning and live my life by the power of his strength. Praise the Lord. He is true. So when truth and the spirit of truth is at work in you, you will not know how to lie. Even if you look for lie, you will not find it. Number one, fear will depart from you. Because some of the lies we tell is the fear of people. We want to please others. Do you get it? We don't want them to be angry of the truth. Some of it is a habit. Praise the Lord. Some of it we are just formed, you know, in the negative part. Praise the Lord. It's just a lifestyle. But today, the Holy Spirit is telling us we should take his ability, the spirit of truth. We should take his strength. He said, cheer up. For you are an overcomer. For greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. Praise the Lord. So when you rely on your ability, you will do it over and over and over again. But when you get to a point where you understand that the cross is for a purpose. Why did Christ die? Christ have come. Christ have lived the life of flesh. Christ now made a conclusion and said, without me, you can do nothing. Praise the Lord. And if you got to that conclusion, you should know that he is the truth and he is the life. So for you to live the life of God, you need the life of God walking and flowing in you. Praise the Lord. For you to run the race, you need the strength. For you to walk with God, you need his wisdom. Where is his wisdom? His wisdom is in your spirit. For you to be able to overcome Satan and know his works and his ways, you have to understand that he's not trying to live the way everybody else is living. Praise the Lord. Because somehow we are in the world, like Corinthians was telling us, he's not taking us out of the world. We are in the world, but even the sin that is mentioned in the church cannot be mentioned in the world. Praise the Lord. That is how bad it is. So I'm not really talking about, oh, camouflage. God is in us. So it's not about hiding and doing stuff. No. He knows you more than you know yourself. He knows your strength and your weakness. He said, I am your strength. I am your ability. I am the one that cleanses you. Come to me willingly. Take my strength. That is why he said, he that is weary, he that is heavy laden, he said, give me your yoke, and I will give you rest. What is it that you're battling with? He's not asking you to beg. Philemon said, acknowledge every good thing that is within you in Christ Jesus. What are the good things that are in you? The spirit of truth is in you. The strength of God is in you. Ability to overcome sin. Ability to say, flesh, be silent. Praise the Lord. I was telling the children how I overcame pain in my body. From time to time, pain will lift up the head. What I do, I say, pain, be quiet. For this body is a temple of the living God. You are not allowed to dwell in my body. I was telling them that Jesus, that the Lord created the earth by the power of his word. So I told them, be talkers. Talk to your mind, talk to your body. Apply the word of God. What area do you need strength in? That strength is in you, but go to a point of acknowledging that strength, turning it on, and moving in it, fellowshipping with him day and night. Praise the Lord. Don't rely on your strength. Your strength is not good enough. Your strength is not sufficient enough. Your ability has limitation. If it does not have limitation, Christ would have no need to come. Do you get it? He said the righteousness of a man is like a filthy rag. You know, people tell you, oh, I'm a good person. I'm this, I'm that. But sometimes you think evil. You're in the corner of your room. Some thoughts pop up about things that are not true. Praise the Lord. So now how do we overcome such thoughts? We overcome them by the word. Because we are defied from within. So evil thoughts, evil ideas defy the temple. Praise the Lord. Do we understand that sin is not just sleeping with someone, you know, just lying? It's deeper than waters. Little things. So whenever you get to that point, the book of 1 John says, confess it and he will forgive. Praise the Lord. So even thoughts and impulse, even if it's not just about people, bitterness, you're in your heart, you're in your house, you begin to think, oh, what that person said, what he did, this is what he meant, this is what he's saying is about me. Meanwhile, the person did not even remember you. Suddenly, strife will rise, bitterness will rise. He said, the heart of man is exceedingly wicked. Who can know it? But Christ has given us his ability to rule over our mind. Not just rule over our mind, rule over our lifestyle. Rule flesh. The flesh is all about looking good. Nothing more, nothing less. Praise the Lord. The flesh is about, oh, satisfying the body. Whether it's right or wrong. But the day we come, when this flesh will expire, when he expires, your spirit will face judgment with what the flesh has committed. That's why he said, rule your body from your spirit. Rule weaknesses. Identify where the enemy has gotten hold of you. Identify it. Use the word of God. Use the power of the Holy Spirit. Use the name, the power in the name. He's not asking you to plead. He said his power came for you. Praise the Lord. And that power is not with any pastor. That power is not on any altar. That power is embedded in your spirit. That power goes wherever you go. So when you are committing adultery, you are committing it with the Holy Ghost. When you're stealing with the Holy Spirit. And he said, these things I will judge. Praise the Lord. When you're lying, remember that you are a vessel filled with the Spirit. Praise the Lord. That's why I advise everybody, do not leave your house in the morning without turning on his ability and receiving his grace. He said, run the race with fear, with trembling. For heaven is a place people decide to go on purpose. It's not a place people say, oh, I'm a good person. I will find my way there when I die. No, you decide to go to heaven when you are alive here. Praise the Lord. He said that place is not a place for lawbreakers, lawlessness. It's a place where people who abide, who keep the commandments, come. Praise the Lord. I don't know if I passed the message across. This is a fresh, brand new year. It's not about New Year resolution. It's about taking on board all that Christ gave you. Praise the Lord. He gave you strength. He gave us his ability. He said, give me your weakness and take mine. Praise the Lord. Let's rise up to our feet. The book of John chapter 10 verse 10 said, the thief cometh to kill, to steal. But Jesus came that we will have life. Not just have life, great life, abundance of life. Life everlasting, good life, joy, peace, strength. Praise the Lord. Let's rise up to our feet. Let's begin to acknowledge his ability at work in us. Ability to walk without sin. For God is a holy God. Without holiness, no man shall